What's good, you guys? I cannot believe I'm saying these words out of my mouth, but I'm gonna be reacting to Rihanna's Lift Me Up Wakanda Forever lyric video. I'm so fucking ready for this movie. I got my tree right here. I got my speaker, y'all see it. I got my laptop right here and I got my coffee. She had a baby and now she's making music again. Get that money. That's the mom grind for real. Don't sleep on the moms. I know I'm late to react to Rihanna, but I've been ducking and dodging this song on the radio just so I could listen to it with y'all. I fucking love Rihanna. For those of you who know me, you already know that's a fact. My car is even named after her, Riri. I've been listening to Rihanna since middle school. From dancing, to being in my feelings, to getting out of my feelings, to feeling confident. Like, her music makes me feel a type of way. If y'all only knew the memories I have that are tied with her music from that era. But even though she was taking a break, she was hustling on her entrepreneurial shit though. Her Fenty Beauty makeup line, her Fenty skincare, and her Savage Fenty lingerie line. Like, come on, bruh. She's been hustling. I also read that this song is a tribute to the late Chadwick Boseman. Let's take a hit for Chadwick. I'm assuming that this song is gonna be in the movie Wakanda Forever. I fucking love Black Panther. When it comes to movies, I be getting so emotional. And yes, I'm a crier.
Yup, I'm a sensitive ass bitch. I'm sensitive as fuck. I'm a fucking sensitive fucking gangster.
Let's just get into it. Rihanna's Lift Me Up. And this is 3 minutes and 17 seconds. Ooh! Oh shit. Bro, we just started, bro, and I'm about to fucking cry.
Lift me up. Hold me down. Keep me close.
Hold up, we're literally only 41 seconds in the song and I'm about to tear up right now. But do y'all fucking hear that? Just the initial sound of the piano and her voice together, that just set an emotional ambient tone. Guitar acoustic? Dude, I'm getting goosebumps. Know that this song is giving a deep, meaningful message for all types of occasions, honestly. And her voice on this track is absolutely soothing. It has a calming effect, but it's how she sings it though. My God, there is so much emotion I can feel in this song, from the lyrics, from Rihanna's voice, the instruments, just everything. Yeah. Period. So far, I'm not gonna frame. She said like a total of 15 words. Do you understand how talented you have to be to sing 15 words in hella different ways? Just from runs? Take a hit. Rest in peace to Chadwick Boseman. Wakanda forever, bitch. Rihanna's vocals go fucking crazy. And she's here to remind us who the fuck Rihanna is. Put some respect on her motherfucking name. I know this song would really hit home for those who experience a loss, especially from someone close. And this song is a great song to honor those who we lost. Don't get me wrong, there are some repetitive parts. But the way Rihanna executes them, because here we are, she executes them in different ways with her voice. Her riffs and runs are beyond impressive. What stood out to me the most was how she sang the lyrics, because the focus was on her voice. The lyrics were very simple, but her voice made it sound more complex. One of my favorite things when an artist gets really into their song is that passion you hear, the sincerity, as if they're really going through that at that moment. And Rihanna sang this song as if it was personal. Of course, I'm gonna give this song a 10 out of 10, not because it's Rihanna, but because I really relate to this song. I felt this song on a personal level. Hearing other people's stories helped me out in my healing journey. I'm hoping that my experience can bring you comfort in your end and give you some closure about somebody understanding where you're coming from. It can feel like a lonely journey, but I promise you, there's people out there that understand you. Chadwick had passed away from cancer, and a lot of my family members had passed away from cancer. My dad, my grandma, my aunt. Recently, when my grandma had passed in September, I actually made a slideshow for the viewing, and a lot of people liked it. That means a lot to me. I would have for surely put this song on that slideshow. And making that slideshow is just my way of showing my grandma that, you know, I love her, you feel me? And I know she's watching over me. Same as my dad, I know he's watching over me. That was the hardest time in my life, and it's still hard. It doesn't get easier, but I figured out how to deal with my emotions in a healthy way. Well, yeah, the song was pretty heavy with some emotions that came to me. I really fuck with this song. Thank you guys for hearing me out. Thank you guys so much for watching till the end. Feel free to comment how you feel about the song, how you feel about anything, you know. Don't forget to give this video a thumbs up. That really helps my videos out. Don't forget to subscribe, support your girl, and I'll see you guys in my next video. But before we go, let's take one more hit, and this hit better be intentional and meaningful. Cheers, you guys. I'm on marijuana. My lean plug, say he'll be here in a sec. I'm getting hot. I'm gonna feel like I'm finna die. Fuck the blunt, fuck your mama. VVS cold like a Arctic tundra.